I am Kinjal Parmar. Welcome back to the video lecture series of Digital Fundamentals. Today we will discuss counters. So let's start with the definition of counters. This digital counters are basically used to count the pulses. Okay, here this digital counter is a sequential digital circuit. Okay, this counter is a sequential digital circuit which is used to count the pulses. Okay, so this digital counter is basically a sequential digital circuit which is used to count the pulses. This sequential digital circuit, that means our counters, which is sequential digital circuit, is goes through a prescribed sequence. Okay, it goes through a prescribed sequence and then count the pulses and such that it counts the value. Okay, such that it counts the value. So this counters is basically used to count the pulses in a prescribed sequence form. Here we have this digital counter is a sequential digital circuit which is used to count the pulses. Okay, so this counters counts the occurrence of events. This counter counts the occurrence of events and generate the timing sequence for controlling a sequential digital circuit. Okay, to control sequential digital circuit using timing sequence. So here we have a counter which is used to control our sequential digital circuits. This counter which counts the binary value is known as binary counter. Okay, a counter which goes through a binary sequence is called as binary counters. Here this n bit counters consist of n flip-flops, so it counts total 2^n values. Okay, here we have a n bit counters, then for n bit counters we have a n flip-flop. Basically this counter is a group of flip-flops. Okay, this counter is a group of flip-flops, that's why to construct counter we have to use flip-flops, and for n bit counter we have to use n flip-flops, and using n flip-flops we can calculate total 2^n values from 0 to 2^n-1. For example, for 3 bit we have to use 3 flip-flops, and for that it counts total 2^3, total 8 states starting from 0 to 7. Okay, so using 3 bits we can calculate 0 to 7 values in this counters. Okay, so whenever we have to design n bit counters, so we have to use n flip-flops, and this n flip-flops can count total 2^n values from 0 to 2^n-1. Here this counter has a counting values. Okay, so each counts. Okay, here in a counters we have a counting value, so each of the counts which counts here in a counter is known as state of the counter. Okay, is known as state of the counter. Each count is known as state of the counters. And here when this counter counts the values, okay, here each of the state of the counter is known as a modulus of that counter. Okay, total values, or says all the possible state which counted by our counter before restarting it is known as modulus of counter. For example, if we have a 3 bit counter, so this 3 bit counter calculates total 2^3, that means total 8 values, that means it counts total 8 counts starting from 0 to 7. So here this 8 counts, so here we have a 8 state of this counter, and this 8 state is known as modulus of that counter. That means for 3 bit modulus of counter is 8. Okay, so this is modulus of the counter. Now let's discuss classifications of counter. So here we have a classifications of counter. We can classify our counter according to clock signal applied, so that we have a two counters, that is asynchronous counter and synchronous counter. Whenever we classify our counter according to clock signal up light. So we have a two types of counter, that is asynchronous counter and synchronous counter. Next we have a classifications according to values of count. Okay, here we have a counters classifications according to counting value. So here we have a up counter, down counter and up and down counter. So let's discuss one by one. So here first we have a asynchronous counter. This asynchronous counter is basically a counter, that means a group of flip-flops in which all the flip-flops do not consist same clock signals. Okay, here this asynchronous and synchronous counters are basically according to clock signal applied. Okay, so here this counter is basically a group of flip-flops. Okay, so this asynchronous counter, that means here in this group of flip-flops, this flip-flops does not consist same signals, same external clock signals. Okay, so here we have a this asynchronous counter. In asynchronous counter, this flip-flops are connected such that first flip-flop is triggered by a external clock signal. Okay, in a first flip-flop clock signal is there, so due to external clock signal first flip-flop will be triggered, and after that output of first flip-flop either Q or Q dash. Okay, we have a two outputs in flip-flop, so output of flip-flops either Q into Q dash, it will be given to second flip-flops. Okay, output of first flip-flop is given to the second flip-flops as a clock. Okay, so here output of first flip-flop is given to the second flip-flop as a clock, then output of second flip-flop is connected as a clock for a third flip-flops, and output of third flip-flop is given to fourth, and so on. Okay, so this is how this asynchronous counter works. First flip-flops will count the value, and then second flip-flops will count the value, and third. Okay, because in a second flip-flops we apply output of first flip-flops as a clock, that's why here first flip-flops will be activated, and after first flip-flops we have a second flip-flops activated. So here all the flip-flops are work in a serial form, that means first flip-flop will be work, then second flip-flop will work, then third flip-flop and fourth, and so on. Okay, so in a asynchronous counter, all flip-flops do not have same clock signals, and here we apply a clock signal such that first flip-flop has external clock signal, and then second flip-flop has a clock signal as output of first flip-flop, third has a clock as a output of second flip-flops, and so on. That's why this asynchronous counter is also known as serial counter. Okay, so this is asynchronous counter. Then here we have a next, that is synchronous counter. This synchronous counter has also a group of flip-flop, but here all flip-flops has same clock signals. Okay, so in synchronous counters all flip-flops are triggered with same external clock signals. Here this in a asynchronous counters all flip-flops are triggered by a same clock signal, that means all flip-flops will be activated at the same time. Okay, all flip-flops will be activated at a same time, that's why this synchronous counter is also known as parallel counter. This synchronous counter is also known as parallel counter, and this synchronous counter is basically faster than asynchronous counter, because in asynchronous counter all flip-flops will work simultaneously parallelly, but in a asynchronous counter all flip-flops will work one by one, that means serially. Okay, that's why this synchronous counter is faster than asynchronous counter. Next we have a up counter. Up counter, that means a counter which counts values from small to large. Okay, up counter, that means it counts the value from small to large, that means 0, 1, 2, 3, then up to n. Okay, so this is how this up counter counts in a upward direction, that's why it is known as up counter. Next we have a down counter. दिस डाउन काउंटर इज बेसिकली अ काउंटर विच काउंट्स द वैल्यू फ्रॉम लार्ज टू स्मॉल. ओके, दिस डाउन काउंटर बेसिकली काउंट्स द वैल्यू फ्रॉम लार्ज टू स्मॉल. फॉर एग्जाम्पल n, n माइनस वन, n माइनस टू, अप टू 3, 2, 1, 0. ओके, सो दिस इज डाउन काउंटर विच काउंट्स इन अ डाउनवर्ड डिरेक्शन. दैट्स वाई इट इज नोन एज अ डाउन काउंटर. Now next we have a up and down counter. This up and down counter is a counter which counts either a small to large count or either a large to small count. Okay, so this up and down counter is basically depending on our requirement, it will count either in a upward directions or in a downward direction. So this is known as up and down counter. Next we have a modulus counter. This is not a classification of counter, but here we have a one kind of counters, this which is known as a modulus of counter. Okay, we know that total number of values counted by our counter is known as modulus of that counter. For example, we have a modulus 16 counter. So this modulo 16 counter, that means it counts total 16 values from 0 to 15. Okay, so this we have a counters which has some modulus. Okay, so this is known as a modulus counter. Now we have a two types of modulus counter. First is a counter which goes through all the possible state of the flip-flops. Okay, all the possible state of our counter before restarting is known as a full modulus counter. Okay, a counter which counts all the possible state of our circuit is known as full modulus counter. And here we have another this counter, that is a counter which does not goes through all the possible state of the counter before restarting is known as a variable length counter. We have some counters in which we have a modulo 12, that means it counts the value up to 12, that means 0 to 11. So for this we have to use 4 flip-flops, but all these 4 flip-flops does not count all the possible state over here. Okay, that's why it is known as a variable modulus counter. A modulus n or mode n counter which counts total n value is also divides a frequency by n. Okay, it also divides a frequency by n of external clock signal. That's why this modulo n counter is also known as divide by n counter. Okay, or frequency divider by n counter. That means if we have an example like design a counter, or says design a frequency divider which divides the frequency by 8, that means 8 total, 8 is equals to 2 raised to 3. So here we have to use 3 bit counter. Okay, so some notations are changed over here, but this basic logical circuitry are same for a modulo n counter or for 3 bit counter. Okay, so this is our modulus counter. So here we have this counter. Counter is basically a group of flip-flops. This group of flip-flops are connected in a such that manner that it counts the pulses applied to the counters. Okay, here we have different types of counter. We have a asynchronous counter in which all the flip-flops will be activated one by one. Then we have a synchronous counter in which all the flip-flops are worked simultaneously, that means parallelly. Then we have a up counter which counts up value. Then we have a down counter which counts in a downward directions. Then we have a up and down counter which can counts both the value either in up directions or either in a down directions. And here we have a this types of counter, that is a modulus counter. Okay, so this is the our counters and its classifications. Thank you.